into a column, you have the dot product. Okay, so you have lambda 1, lambda 2, v1 dot v2. Okay, and what about this one? Who is this?
Lambda 1, v2 dot v1.
Lambda 1, v2 dot v1. But is that different from v1 dot v2? It's the same thing. Okay, so these two are exactly the same.
Lambda 2?
Pardon?
Lambda 1 equals lambda 2?
Oh, but wait a minute. But wait a minute. Lambda 1 is not equal to lambda 2. So what has to happen? V1 dot V2 has to be 0. And therefore they're orthogonal to each other. Since lambda 1 is not equal to lambda 2. Isn't that amazing? V1 dot V2. It is an amazing trick, okay, because you would never have thought to just try to force something with v1 dot v2. Okay, you have to play with v1 dot av2. Okay, it's just amazing.
You actually came up with that.
Remember, the only thing worse than my history is my geography, right? They're both horrible. So yeah, I don't know who came up with it.
It seems
so random. Now, to put sort of climate, still have half an hour, I want to talk about something amazing because, symmetric matrices are nice, orthogonal matrices are nice, but they're square. Okay, and not all matrices are square, so I'm going to start all over, okay? Not a square matrix, okay, 3x4, okay? So let's just randomly fill this up, okay? So instead of asking for audience participation, I'm just going to randomly put in numbers, okay? I'm going to say 9 for Caitlin.
Thank you.
7. Okay, negative 1, negative 4. How about that? Okay.
Really random. This isn't
random. You came up with that.
Nothing rigged at all. It's just completely random.
No.
So there's nothing symmetric about that, right? Okay. We're going to make a symmetric, not just one, but two symmetric matrices.
Symmetrify.
We will symmetrify. No,
is there a button for that in there?
Here's the transcript.
We asked to do it.
Okay, take the transpose. Okay? Something magical happens when you multiply them together. Okay, how big will that product be?
3x3.
Okay? Let's multiply them. You are so going to be shocked.
This would happen.
Why is it so magical?
Wait, is this happening
the
entire
time?
This has been happening
the entire time. You never hear the dark secrets all around.
So this is how you make problems?
I don't tell my secrets.
And then you do the backwards, right?
Now it's in the backwards. How big will that matrix be? 4x4.
Is it also
symmetric? We shall see. This one is hard compared to this one. But we need the same idea. That one is trivial. Okay, if A, first let's talk about size. If A is M by N. Clearly. How big is A transpose?
N by N.
If you multiply A by A transpose in that order, how big is
M
by Montana by Montana. A transpose by A will be Nebraska by Nebraska. Okay? So they're not the same size, but they're both square. Okay. If you take the transpose of that product. A transpose A, and then A transpose. Symmetric. Chicago.
I know.
Now, this part is magic, okay? And I hope this will be new to most, if not all of you. Okay, characteristic polynomial, right? Compute matrices, characteristic polynomial. Okay, some nastiness, okay, big numbers, right? Okay, let's look for the eigenvalues. So compute, solve, and that they're going to be irrational, okay? They might even be imaginary, okay? Oh, however, wait a minute, it's a symmetric matrix, okay? So if you believe me, the eigenvalues should be all real.
Yes.
Okay? So let's find the numeric roots. Oh, okay, so. What do you see? Okay.
32.
32, 76, and 180.
Yes.
Okay. All of them are real. Okay. And they're irrational. Okay. Trust me, they're irrational. Okay. The other matrix, okay, they both came from A. One is A transpose, one is A transpose. Compute matrices, characteristic polynomial. Do you see a similarity?
It's
1 degree higher. Are the coefficients different?
Which makes sense.
No. Okay. So are the roots going to be exactly the same?
No.
Yes.
But you have one extra root.
Zero.
Okay, because x is now a factor. What? Seriously. Okay. This is something I actually did not know 10 years ago. Okay, when I started writing the book, I did not know this. Okay, so this came as a shock to me.
Okay. Oh my god.
Okay, I knew that A transpose would be symmetric. I knew that A transpose A would be symmetric. I didn't know that their eigenvalues would be exactly the same, except for the extra zeros. Okay, that part is also very deep, and that is covered in the first half of chapter 9. Okay? Because what else do you notice about the eigenvalues? Aside from being real, what kind of numbers are they? Aside from ugly. All of them are They're all positive. Okay? That part is not at all obvious. Okay? That the eigenvalues of A transpose and A transpose A are all positive, never negative. Okay? Okay. And that brings me to probably the most important factorization in modern linear algebra, and it is called. It is called the SVD decomposition. Also called the singular. That's redundant.
Do you want to decomp twice or something?
Then you'll decompose.
Decomposition.
Okay. To demonstrate the SVD, let's see. I believe I have an example. Yes, here we go. Okay. This is a 2x3 matrix. Okay? So it's not square. All right. The software here does have a routine, compute matrices, SVD. It's right here. Okay, so we've never done this in class. And boom, there's the answer. Okay? So the SVD. Okay, it's a 2 by 2, followed by a 2 by 3, okay, and by a 3 by 3. Okay, that's a 3 by 3 matrix. Okay, okay, so 2 by 2 times 2 by 3 makes 2 by 3, followed by 3 by 3, still 2 by 3. Okay. What did it do? What did it do? Okay. Do you recognize what kind of special matrix this is?
It's
symmetric. That's correct. It is also its rotation.
It's something with reflection.
Yeah, so are they perpendicular to each other? Yes. Unit vectors? Yeah, sure. There you go. Okay. So this is an orthogonal matrix. Okay. This, it's not obvious, but this is also an orthogonal matrix. Okay. If you don't believe me, and why should you? Take the transpose, and then we'll multiply them together, right? And we'd better get the identity, something close to the identity, right? Right on. Okay. So. Multiply them together, you're gonna get. Ooh, is that the identity?
Kind of close.
Kind of close.
It's
an approximation, right? So that's almost 0000000. Is that
it?
Okay. So the first and the last are orthogonal matrices. Okay. All right. What are these? What's so special about this matrix? Well, what kind of matrix? If I cover this, what does that matrix look like? That 2 by 2 matrix.
It's a diagonal
matrix. Okay. So the singular value composition is made of an orthogonal matrix, a quasi diagonal matrix, okay, and another orthogonal matrix. Okay. And multiply it together, you get the original matrix. Okay? So, this is an approximation. How do we get the exact answer? I can actually do it for you. Because this is it's sort of rigged because I don't want decimals. Okay? I don't want irrational numbers. Okay? Okay, so we're gonna play the same game that we did with the 3 by 4 earlier. Okay, this is 2 by 3, it's smaller. Okay? So we're going to take the transpose, compute matrices, transpose, okay, and we're going to multiply them together. Okay, what kind of a matrix is that? Square, and it is symmetric. Okay, compute matrices. Eigen. We're going to look for the eigenvectors. Okay. So there are two eigenvalues, 36,100 and 422,225. Okay. But the eigenvectors are very small. Okay. Are those unit vectors already? No, not quite, but they're not too far from being unit vectors, right? Okay. So we're going to turn the -431 into -4 and then 3. The length of that vector is 5. Now it's a unit vector. Okay. And this will turn into a 3 and a 4.
Also
5. Okay. These will go into the columns for the first matrix. Okay. See how. Oh, look. 0.6, 0.8, that's this one, right? And 0.8 minus 0.6, sort of. Okay. Negatives, okay, that's forgivable, right? Plus or minus a unit vector is still a unit vector, right? Okay, so why is this first, though? Is there a good reason? Yes. 4225 is bigger than 36,100, okay? So the singular value decomposition arranges these numbers in decreasing order. Okay, but wait a minute, that's not clear. What do you think? Where do you think this came from?
Super.
what? The square, correct. Okay? The square root of this number is this. The square root of this number is this. Okay? So, yeah, let's change to the 1/2, and we're going to get, boom, 665. OMG. To the 1/2, we're going to get, boom, oops, square of the second.
How does the ordering of this one?
There, 190.
Like,
yeah.
How would we have made sure that we could have put the 190 in the top left and the 665 in the bottom right?
Oh, yeah, because the SVD goes in decreasing order. Okay, so 665 is bigger than 190.
So we would do them all and then put the biggest one in.
Correct. Now we would all put the biggest one in. Okay. Now, here's the magic. Where did the third matrix come from? Okay. If you take the transpose, okay, this one, right? And then multiply by 3/5, 4/5. Okay? We're going to get that vector. Okay? Is that a unit vector? Hell no. Compute matrices, the norm. How long is that vector? Ooh, 665. What a coincidence. Nothing surprises you anymore. Okay, so if you divide by 665, now it's a unit vector. Ooh. Okay, why are we doing this? Because I want to show you how this matrix was put together. Okay, so we get this vector. What is this vector approximately? Boom.
0.5.
Is that the first row or the first column?
It's the first column. No, it's the negative.
Yeah. The closest.
It's
the
first row.
It's the first row.
Yeah.
Ooh. Oh, no.
Ooh, magic.
Okay. It's not negative in my
own. Yeah, it's not negative. This is negative. It's the first row. It's the first row. Okay. And if you multiply the second vector, okay, you're gonna get not the unit vector again, and then compute the norm. Oh, 190. Oh, big surprise. So divide by 190, and we should get the second row. Or will we?
Why the row not called? Why the row not called?
Because it's transpose. Okay, there's a reason for that. Okay, so let's approximate that. And we get, boom, is that the second row?
Where is it?
Where are we?
It's
the first one.
Okay, remember there's a negative sign. Yes, we're off by a negative sign.
Yeah, but it's fine.
So, but it's fine, right? It's negative 0.789, positive 0.31, negative. Okay, so why is this so important, okay? Why is this so important? I want to show you something from somebody else's work, okay? So, but it's a very good paper. So let's look at it.
So somebody else agrees with you on this?
Yes, but yeah. So this is basically the nature of the singular value decomposition. He's doing it for square matrices, okay? So it can work out in general as long as you put extra zeros either on the right or on the bottom. Okay? So when it's underdetermined, you will have extra zeros on the right. If it's overdetermined, you will have extra zeros on the left, on the bottom. Okay? So this is very, very relevant if you ever took a digital photograph.
Oh, there's
purpose for it. Okay? So, okay, you can think of a picture as a matrix, okay, divided into pixels, okay? So you could have like 800 pixels horizontally, 500 pixels vertical, okay? How much data will that involve? 5 times a 4D times 10,000?
400,000.
A lot. And if you want it in color, okay, computer science students? Okay.
E multiplied by 3.
How much? Yeah, multiply by 3 because you have an RGB code. Okay? And each of those requires 1 byte. Right?
Okay.
Yeah, 256 codes. Okay? That's a lot of information. Okay? So, of course, if you upload a picture to Facebook, they compress it because they don't want megs and megs of data. They'll tolerate 500K, okay, but not 8 meg. Okay? So the SVD works by, remember how those numbers were in decreasing order?
Yes.
Those were not the eigenvalues, but rather the square root of the eigenvalues. Mm-hmm. Okay? So those are called the singular values of our matrix. Okay? If you only keep some of the singular values and the associated eigenvectors, you can still get a fairly good representation of your matrix. Okay? Here's what it means. Okay? So you have 500 by 500 matrix. You will have 500 eigenvalues. Okay, but if you only pick a few of them, how many do we have now? 10 eigenvalues. Okay, the picture is already fairly close. Okay, but that's kind of lazy. Let me do more. Oh, there you go, 40. If you use 40 singular values, it's already pretty good. Okay, so if you actually physically shrink that image, the resolution will be good enough to look at on a telephone, right? If you're looking at it in a big screen, then yeah, it's gonna look gross, right? This was very important when they were sending, spaceships to Mars or whatever. Okay? Because one of the first things you'd want to know is, did your spaceship land on quicksand or something? Okay, so they wanted to take a picture of the foot of the spacecraft to make sure it's on solid ground, okay? So if that's megs and megs of data, it's gonna take a long time to transmit, okay? They want to do fast. Okay, so all you need is a low resolution picture, but of course you want the high resolution images to study later, okay? So, data compression is one of the reasons why the SVD is important.
So this is only sending over 40 bytes times 3.
Okay. So what's okay? So yeah, you know what? Let me lose.
Because that seems rather absurd. That's possible.
Okay, it's almost like witchcraft. Yes. So so you're going to have a 500 by 800 picture. Okay. So it will factor as a 500. By 500 matrix on the left, which is orthogonal, and then 500 by 800 matrix in the middle, where you will have sigma 1 to sigma 500, and all zeros here, okay? And then you will have an 800 by 800 orthogonal matrix on the right. Okay. Now, if the first few eigen singular values are very large compared to the others, okay, if you only keep the first 5 here, and the first 5 columns here, and the first 5 rows here, okay, the answer you get will already be very close to the original matrix. And that's the last thing I want to demonstrate, and we'll be done. And we can party with the science students. Okay. So, yeah.
Professor, is that because it's no longer underdetermined?
No. It will still be the same size. It will still be 500 by 800.
But you're only really concentrating on the first.
Correct.
So therefore,
the first few. No.
No
you know, there will be less accuracy. Okay, let me show you. Okay, so I have this 3x4 matrix. Okay, let's look at the SVD. Okay, compute matrices SVD. Okay, nastiness, right? But the first two singular values are bigger than the last one. Okay, so here's what we're gonna do. We will take only the first two columns here. Okay, so I'm going to put that down here. And then this 2x2. Okay, and then we have a two, these two rows over here. Okay, let me make it a little bit smaller. Okay, so that's all together, and we will compute the answer. So that's also a 3x4 matrix, right? Compare it now to the original. Okay, so this is the new one. The original is up here. Okay, so the 5 is really bad, right? Okay, but the 8 is pretty good.
Seven
is
also good.
Yeah, but the 7 is also good. Okay. Now, of course, this is a very small matrix. Okay. If we're talking 500 by 800, okay, and you're looking at the picture, okay, the pixels in an ordinary photograph, they're not entirely random. Okay. Because, you know, the color over here is going to be very similar to the color over there and so on. Okay. So often, when you take enough of the singular values, what you get will be a very good approximation for the original matrix. Okay. So, but the advantage is that you need a lot less data, okay? Yeah, because, okay, back to our computation. We have 5 times 8, 0, 0, 0, 0, times, you know, 3 matrices for R, for G, for B, okay? But if you only keep 5 of this, you need data for only 5 numbers, okay? And you have 5 columns of 500, 5 times 500. Okay, that's certainly not as big as 800 times 500. But you have another one here, 5 times 800. So it's really just 5 times 800 plus 500 instead of 800 times 500. That's a lot smaller, right? And of course, you need the 5 singular values. Okay, so it's a lot less.
Can they check which ones that they need? Or how do they know which ones, like how many
you need? Well, of course, it's just the tip of the iceberg. Okay, so there are algorithms to decide how accurate it would be if they only several curves. But I can give you a simple answer, okay? If the eigenvalues, singular values are in decreasing order, okay, and if you take up the sigma k, then the error will be at most 1 minus summation of sigma I from k plus 1 to m divided by summation of sigma I from 1 all the way to all. Okay, so basically, yeah, if your eigenvalues are 50, 40, 20, 10, then yeah, the total would be 90, 120. If you took 3, your error would be less than 1 over 12. Okay, so, right. Well, actually, yeah. So we don't need that because this is the... What's left over. So that's how I think.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. And thank you, Ryan, and Ben, and for organizing.
That was a fun way to
Yeah.